Let's pray.
我们在天上的父，感谢赞美你。
Our Father in heaven, we give you thanks and we give you praises.
感谢你每天的带领和看顾。
We thank you for leading us and guiding us every day, and we thank you for watching over us.
感谢主耶稣的宝血为我们洗净我们的罪孽。
And we thank you for your precious blood, which shed to cover our sins.
我们愿意献上自己当作活祭。
We are willing to offer ourselves as a living sacrifice.
求主悦纳。
And may God accept it.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
We pray in Jesus' victorious name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
我们来唱赞美诗，献祭于主。
Let's sing and praise my soul, the King of Heaven.Now we will begin our second worship. Please turn off or silence your phone and let's prepare our hearts for the Lord.
下面我们读诗篇第一百零六篇一节。
Our call to worship is in Psalms 106, chapter 1.
七，
你们要赞美耶和华，要尊谢耶和华，因他很美善，他的慈爱永远长存。
Let's read it together. Praise ye the Lord, O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endure forever.
请大家起立，我们一起唱诗歌，赞美我主君王。
Please rise, let's sing Praise My King. We thank you for your amazing grace. All of us that are blessed, we come before you to worship
you.
Oh Lord, what kind of people are we that we have received such a grace from you? Our Father, you are still the king on the throne, and you are in charge and in control of everything. We are chosen by you, and we are the sheep on the green grass. And we want to come into your door with a pure heart, and we want to praise and come into your yard. You are our shelter, you are our rock, and you are our tent.
主啊，求你今天自己亲自举手为登宝座，掌完权，求你的圣灵运行在我们当中。
Lord, may you be on the throne and may you be the control of all things.
你自己亲自向我们每个人说话，因为你的话语是我们生命的泉源。
And may you talk to each and every one of us because your words is the origin of our life.
求主，你的膏油膏你今天出口的仆人圣牧师。
And Lord, may you anoint your servant, Pastor Sun, today that will be speaking.
求你使他要说出的话语带着，属天来的能力，句句带着你要赐给我们的恩典。
That the words that he speak will have the power from above, and to bless us with those words.
主啊，今天不无论是我们在这里的，还是在家中的，听到你话语的话，话语的时候。
Oh, today, whether we're here or we're home, when we listen to your words.
我们同感一点，同盟造就。
That we are united on one spirit, and we are all edified.
我们从开始到末了吧。我们的崇拜完完全全交托在你的手里面。
From beginning to end, we commit our worship into your hands.
自己求主自己管理整个会场，主啊，集建会场。
May Lord be in control of the whole worship, and may Lord cleanse our worship.
我们把颂赞荣耀都归给你。
We give glory, praises, and thanks unto you.
祷告祈求奉靠救主耶稣基督得胜的名字。
We pray in Jesus' victorious name.
Amen.
大家请坐。
Please be seated.
我们现在读使徒信经，作为我们信仰的告白。
Let's read the Apostle Creed as a confession to our faith.
起，
我信上帝全能的父，创造天地的主。我信我主耶稣基督，上帝的独生子，因圣灵感孕，由圣灵玛利亚所生，在本丢比拉多手下受难，被钉于十字架，受死，埋葬，降在阴间，第三天从死人中复活，升天，坐在全能父上帝的右边，将来必从万族降临，审判活人死人。我信圣灵。我信圣而公之教会，我信圣徒相同，我信罪得赦免，我信身体复活，我信永生。Amen.
Let's read it together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead.On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of sin, and the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
下面我们用
祈
愿文的方式来读箴言书24:1-5.
Our responsive reading is in Proverbs chapter 24, verse 1-5.
你不要嫉妒二人，也不要轻易与他们相处。
因为他们是以多相报，他们的报应必增多。
房屋因智慧建造，要因聪明立稳。
其中因知识充满，会有美好宝贵的家族。
智慧人大有能力，有知识的人立上加利。
Let's read it together. But not the envious against.Evil men need a desire to be with them, for their hearts study destruction, and their lips talk of mischief. Through wisdom is a house built, and by understanding it is established, and by knowledge shall the chambers be filled with all precious and pleasant riches. A wise man is strong, yea, a man of knowledge increases strength.
现在是信誉的时间，钢琴演奏我们组里的爱的小朋友。
Next, we have our music offering by Melody D.
弟兄姐妹好，我们今天特别邀请了一个小姐妹，她跟我的名字一样叫 Melody， 她只学了几课啊，大概一两个月吧。然后她的妈妈是 Karen 是矫声的工作人员，谢谢。父亲在后面的 Chris， 谢谢 Melody 跟我们弹一首《耶稣爱我》。那我们会弹三遍，前面两遍弹完以后，第三遍我们可以一起唱。
Thank you.
Thank you.
谢神，谢谢诗班跟谢诗诗歌。
Thank God.
下面我们读经《哥林多前书》六章十二节。
Our scripture reading is in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 12.
其凡事我都可行，但无独有益处。凡事我都可行，但无论哪一件，我从不受他的辖制。
All things are lawful to me, but not all things profit. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any.
下面是牧师正道的时间，我们请牧师。今天题目是凡事都可行，但不都要益处，请牧师。
Our topic today is all things are lawful to me, but not all things profit. Let's welcome our pastor.
请起立。
Please rise.
我们在天上父，感谢赞美你。
Our Father in heaven, we thank you and we praise you.
你蒙恩的儿女，奉主耶稣基督的名在这里聚集。
Those of us that are blessed by your grace, in the name of our Lord, we come and gather here.
主你与我们同在。
May you be with us.
主你的圣灵充满在座的每一位。
And may you fulfill each and everyone here with the Holy Spirit.
是听和讲的人都同蒙一灵。
So that the ones that speak and the ones that listen, we are blessed by one spirit.
愿你在我们当中居首位，掌王权。
And may you be in authority among us.
愿你得到你该得的荣耀与赞美。
And may you have the glory that is worthy to you.
也愿所有聚集在你的面前的人，无论是在会所或者在线上，都同。蒙造就，同得恩福。
And may all those that are in front of you, whether they're here or whether they're online, they are all edified and they are renewed.
在这个混乱、充满苦难的世界
，in this world that is full of tribulation and suffering,
你是我们藏身之处。
You are our hiding place.
你是我们的拯救。你是我们的依靠。
You are our savior and you are our shelter.
凡劳苦担重担的人可以来到你的面前。
Those that bear the hardship and bear the responsibility, they can come before you.
你必须说，我们可以得清醒，得安息。
You promise us that we could be awake and we also could rest inside.
我们今天来到你面前，求你垂听我们出生还没有出生的祷告。
We come before you today, and may you listen to our utter and unutter prayer.
求你怜悯这个世界，也特别求你怜悯美国。
May you have mercy upon this world and especially America.
当瘟疫泛滥的时候，主啊，求你继续坐着为王。
When the pandemic is everywhere, may you continue to be the king.
主啊，求你让每个人都能够俯伏在你的面前，悔改我们的罪，悔改我们所有的过犯。
And may you let everyone bow down before you and repent for our sin and all our wrongdoing.
主啊，求你怜悯这个国家，让瘟疫能够早日得到控制。
And may you have mercy upon this country and let the pandemic be controlled.
那不管发生什么事情，求你让我们向你的敬拜，听你的话，永远是自由的。
And no matter what happened, may you let our worship and our learning of your words be a freedom for us.
所以求你这时候看顾那些不能出门的，在家的，或者现在在无论在什么地方。弟兄姐妹，求你都与他们同在。
Lord, may you also look after those brothers and sisters that aren't able to make it, that is home, that is somewhere. May you be with them.
除去我们一切的惧怕和忧虑。
And may you do away with all our fear and our worry.
让我们因着长生在主里面，我们有平安，有喜乐。
And it's because that we are able to hide within God that we have joy and we have peace.
今天我来到你面前，也求你向我们说话。
And today we come before you, and may you speak to us.
让我们不仅听到，而且行道。
So that we not only listen, but we also take action.
我们这时候纪念主耶稣在地上教导他的门徒，这样祷告说。
Remember what the Lord on earth told his disciple and said. Our Father who art in heaven.Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory, forever. Amen. Please be seated.
我们今天的题目是凡事都可行但不都有益处。
Our topic today is all things are lawful to me, but not all things profit.
以弗所书二章十节告诉我们说我们原是他的工作在基督里造成的。
Ephesians chapter 20 verse 10 said, For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus,unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them.
人在神的永恒计划里面是最伟大的神的杰作。
The people that are in the everlasting plan of God is his greatest workmanship.
我想在座的很多人都很熟悉创世纪。
I'm sure everyone is familiar with the book of Genesis.
神创造一切的东西都是圣经是这样讲神说有光就有了光
God have created everything and it said in the Bible when God said when there is light there is light
那只有人是神照着他的形象的样子来造的
and only human is created after the image of God
那因为我们人是照着神的形象来造的所以呢，我们要彰显神的荣耀。
And because we are created after His image, we need to manifest His glory.
很多人在这个世上不知道为什么活。
Many people in this world they do not know why they live.
有一些人说，我在生在这个世上就是为了吃东西吧。
Some say I live in this world just to eat.
我要吃遍所有的东西，四川的、湖南的、蒙古的，所有的东西都要吃遍。
I want to eat all the great food, all the cuisines all over the world.
所以他活的是为了吃。
So the meaning of for him is to eat.
如果我们活的就是为了吃，那我们跟那些动物有什么不同呢？
But if we live just to eat, then what difference?Are we compared to the animals?
动物也就是整天就吃。
The animals also eat every day.
我以前呢帮人家养过羊。
Before I raised sheep for people before.
羊的生活是真的很简单。
And the lifestyle of a sheep is very simple.
整天就是吃。
They just eat all day.
他也不用想要看电视啊，看报纸。还有玩手机，他不用，他整天就吃。
And it doesn't need to think about watching TV or playing the phone. All they do is eat.
那我们人如果整天就为了吃，为了玩，那其实我们跟动物就没有两样。
And us human, if we just eat every day and play every day, then we are no different compared to the animals.
在路加福音十九章里头讲了一个比喻。
In Luke chapter 19, there is a parable.
他想到有一位贵胄要往远方去。
A certain nobleman went into a far country.
他交给他十个仆人，每人一锭银子去做生意。
He delivered his 10 servant £1 each to trade.
那等到他回来的时候，十个仆人就来交账。
And when he returned, the 10 servant would call onto him.To show how much was gained by trading.
有一些呢，他拿了这主人给的这锭银子，已经赚了另外的 十锭，有一些五锭，有些是两锭。
Some have double the money they got, some have earned 50%, some have earned 2 pounds.
那只有一个，啊，他把主人的这锭银子就把它包起来。
And there is only one that took the pound and wrapped it in a napkin.
结果呢，那前面把主人的这一锭银子去做买卖有赚的，所有都得到称赞。
Those that took the pound and traded, they were praised.
但是这个没有把主人的这个银子去做买卖的，这个就被主责备，主叫他为恶仆。
But the one that haven't traded, he was blamed, and the Lord called him a wicked servant.
我们在读这个圣经的时候，我想在马太福音25章里头讲到相似的事情。
And when we read this parable, also in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, it's a very similar parable.
那也是讲到有一些人呢，得了5000两银子，有些得了2000两银子，有一个得1000两银子。
It said that some people got 5,000 pounds, some people got 2,000, and some people got 1,000.
那其中这两个比喻有什么不同呢？
So what is the difference between these two parables?
Okay, 你在读英文的时候呢，它这个马太福音里头讲到五千、二千，它所用的字是 talent， 中文我们翻译成他连得。
So the measuring unit is in talent.
Okay, 那 talent 呢？我们知道就是我们的才干。
And to modern English, talent is our ability.
也是我们的恩赐，神给个人的恩赐不同。
And it's also our blessing by God, and God gives different blessings to everyone.
Okay, 我看那个小 Melody 在弹琴的时候，我知道神给她有个恩赐是弹琴。
And when we look at Melody, we know she is blessed with the gift of playing the piano.
我有幸跟她弹过两次话。
And I have spoken with her a couple of times.
非常的聪明。
And she is very smart.
这是神给她的那个恩赐吧。
And this is blessed by God to her.
她有，我没有。
She has the blessing I don't.
我们愿意听她弹琴，但是我相信我一弹的话，这里所有的人肯定要走开了。
So we want to listen to her play the piano, but if I play, everyone is going to leave.
但是神赐予每个人的恩赐，还有我们的时间，有一天神都要来跟我们算账。
But all the talent that's blessed to everyone by God, and also the timing, one day God will come and ask us.
神给你的才能，你有没有用来侍奉神
？The talent that God has given you, have you used it to serve God?
所以神将来有一天要来。跟我们算账。
So one day God will come and ask us.
我们知道这个，那个拿了一千，然后最后什么都没有，什么买卖都没有做的人，也是被主人责备。
And we know the one that also took the money and did not trade also were blamed by the master.
那也就是说，如果神给你恩赐，你不用来侍奉神，有一天神来跟你算账的时候，我们是要受责备的，而且圣经里头讲得很严重，这个人要被扔在外面黑暗里哀哭切齿。
So if God had given us talent and we did not use it, then God will come and one day and blame us, and we will be left in the dark, garnishing our teeth.
我相信在我们当中有很多人很有才能，但是他是隐藏起来。
And I strongly believe among us, many people have talent, but they are hiding.
我不知道，但是神知道。
I do not know, but God do know.
你有用它去侍奉神，或者没有？有时候我知道，有时候我不知道，但是神一定知道。
If you have used the talent to serve Him or not, God knows.
所以我们真的不要埋没我们的才能，我们要来侍奉。
So let's not hide our talent and let's use it to serve God.
Okay, 我刚才讲说那个这个这里呢， 这个十个古人都拿的都是一样，都是一两银子。
So I said before, the 10th servant, they all had the same amount. They were given £1.
那这个银子呢，在圣经里头，银是代表救赎。
And the silver in the Bible represents salvation.
我们每个人得了救赎，是不是都一样？
Isn't the salvation we all receive the same?
我们得到神的生命是不是一样的？
And is it the life that we receive from God the same?
没有一个人说我是得了两条，我们都是得了一条属灵的生命。
Nobody is going to say I gained two life. Everyone is going to say I gained one.
我们每个人都是一样。
And everyone is the same.
但是有一些人呢，就他这个属灵的生命。他用来又带了别人信主，有些人带的多，有些人带的少。
But some people, the spiritual life they gain, they used it and to bring more people.
有不少的基督徒，他们只满足于说，我不做坏事，我不犯罪，我就做好一个好人。
And many Christians, they are satisfied with being not doing the wrong thing, not doing sins, and being a good person.
带不带人来信主，这是次要的。
Whether or not they bring people to believe in the Lord is less important.
但是这里，这个比喻告诉我们说，有一天神要跟我们算账。
But this parable here tells us that one day God will come and ask us.
你带过一个人来信主吗？
Did you bring someone to believe in the Lord?
你有没有拿你属灵的这个生命去买卖，去侍奉神，去带更多的人来信主吗？
Did you use your spiritual life to trade? Did you use your spiritual life to serve? Did you use your spiritual life to bring more people to the Lord?
有些人来到教会说：“牧师，你整天这样讲，听不听无所谓。”
Some people come here and they say, "Pastor, you say these things every day, so whether I listen or not is not important."
如果我整天在讲我自己的话，你们可以不听。
But if I am talking about my own words, then you do not have to listen.
如果我是在讲神的话
，But if I'm talking about the word of God,
你听不听是很要紧的事情。
You listen or not is very important.
神说，有一天他要跟你算账。
God said one day he will come and ask you.
他给你的这个属灵的生命，你又赚了多少
？The spiritual life he have given you, how much did you trade?
这是很明显的。
And this is very obvious.
没有一个人能例外。
Nobody is an exception.
所以我希望弟兄姐妹，每个弟兄姐妹回去回想一下。在我一生中，在我当基督徒的这么多年里头，我真的确确实实、真真实实的带过一个人来信主吗
？So I want everyone to go back and look back in their life. All the years I've been a Christian, did I bring someone to believe in the Lord?
如果没有
，If I haven't，
如果今天主就来了
，And if Lord is here today，
或者你今天去见主了
，Or today you go and meet the Lord。
难道我们要两手空空去见主吗
？Are we gonna go empty-handed？
到时候这个吃亏，那真的非常的可怕。
Then we will be in a bad shape。
如果我们只满足于我跟世上所有的所谓的好人一样生活，我不害人。我不犯罪，你就满足了，那我们真的是很危险。
And if we are just satisfied being like every other good person, that we do not do wrongdoings and we do not do sin, then we are in a dangerous spot.
Okay, 我们再下面看。这圣经告诉我们的，凡事不都有益处。
The Bible tells us not all things profit.
保罗不是跟哥林多教会说凡事都可以做，只要没有害处就可以。
It's not that Paul had told the church of Corinthians that all things you can do as long as it does no harm.
他是说凡事都可以做， 但不都有益处。
He said, all things are lawful unto me, but all things are not profitable.
犯罪作恶的事情，这个是有害处，我们不能做。
Things that are a crime and things that are a sin we cannot do.
不犯罪不作恶，那就只要这个事情不是犯罪不是作恶，我就可以做吗？
So if the things is not a crime and not a sin, then could we do it?
不够。
That's not.
我们还要问这个事情有没有益处？
We also have to ask, do this thing have profit? Is it profitable?
有没有容神益人
？And is it according to God's will and benefit the people?
Okay, 比如说我今天看电视、看连续剧、看通宵。
For example, if we're watching the television show all night.
我们在座的有没有这样人这样看电视剧、看通宵
？Have we done this before?
有没有找牌打通宵？
And we played cards all night.
有没有？我告诉你，有，有这个人是谁？我，这个我都干过。那我在打牌的时候，我在看电视、看通宵的时候，我这个又不妨碍你，又不害人嘛。
So when I'm watching television, I'm playing cards all night.I'm not doing anyone harm.
但是神不是让基督徒只问这个人对别人有没有害处，是不是犯罪？神是问我们，你这样做有没有益处
？But God is not just telling the Christian to ask everything we do is it harmful to other, but also to ask is it profitable to us.
我记得我在大陆的时候，如果世界杯来的时候。那哇，作为男的就有借口，而且理直气壮的看通宵。
I remember back in China when they have the World Soccer Cup. As long as you are a male, then you are staying up all night to watch it.
那我们觉得当时在看的时候，哇，非常的激动。那但是真的你静下来的时候，里面好像亏了什么东西。
And we remember we are so into it when we're watching it, but once it's over, you come down there and we lack something.
因为神说，凡事都可行，那不都有益处，但是这件事情有没有益处
？Because God said all things are lawful to me, but all things are not profitable. So, is this thing profitable?
所以弟兄姐妹，今天我希望我们大家每做一件事情的时候。不要只问这害不害人，这是犯不犯罪，而要问这有没有益处。
So, brother, sister, when we start from today, when we do things, let's ask not only is this harmful, is this a sin, but also is this profitable.
当瘟疫来的时候，很多人就被关在家里。
When we have the pandemic, a lot of people is locked in their home.
那在这个家里，我要做什么事情呢
？So in our home, what kind of things should we do?
我知道有一些人就在那里，哇，化了几十个不同的妆。
So some people, they put on different makeup, a lot of makeup.
然后，反正手机嘛，照过来照过去，然后就发在这个朋友圈。
And they took many pictures and sent it to their Facebook.
Okay, 这样做有益处吗
？But is this kind of thing profitable?
Okay, 所以真的我们要问我们的时间是怎么用的。
So we need to ask ourselves, how are we using our time?
Okay, 接下去凡事都可行，但凡事都不受。
Not be brought under the power of any.
有一个传道人，他自己做见证。
There is a missionary and he had a testimony.
他这个传道人呢，平时他压力很重。
This missionary, he is oftentimes he's under tremendous pressure.
所以呢，他怎么样去减压呢
So how did he relieve his stress?
啊，结果他听人家讲说，种花可以减压。
So he heard that running a garden and raising flower could relieve stress.
所以他开始买了一盆来种。
So he brought a plant to grow it.
啊，但是一盆够不够？
But is one plant enough? It's not.
啊，就开始一盆又一盆的买。
So he brought one plant after another.
啊，去 Home Depot 买，去什么这个 Key Food 买。哇，买了整个家，哎呀，就是很多很多的这个花，就像一个花园一样。
So he brought, he went to Home Depot, he went to Key Food, and then he brought many plants, and his house became like a garden.
啊，接着他就上网看书，这些花应该怎么种。
And then he looked up books online to how to raise these plants.
啊，然后呢，他这个。这样的阳光是不是太强啊？然后呢，要喷什么样的水？要下什么样的肥料
？And then he looked up. Do we have enough sunlight? Are we using the right water? What kind of fertilizer should we?
结果呢，每一次他要做预备讲章的时候，他的头脑充满了花。
And every time when he gives speech, his head is full of raising the plants.
在祷告的时候也想到花。
And then when he is praying, he's also thinking about the plants.
他想到的时候，他想，哎呀，今天太阳这么猛，我的花没有盖好。
And when he's talking about God's word, he also thinks about the plant. Oh, it's very sunny today. Does the plants have enough shades?
种花是不是犯罪？不是犯罪。
Is raising a plant a sin? It's not a sin.
种花有没有益处
？Is there benefits to raising a plant? Yes, a little bit.
那这个传道人的问题是什么？他受了他的什么？
瑕疵。
瑕疵嘛。
But what is the problem of this missionary? He is under the power of it.
所以我们在做什么事情的时候，如果他已经影响到你的侍奉，影响到你的你家庭的生活或者什么，这时候。我们要停下来想想，是不是应该停止
？So no matter what we do, if it affects your serving God, if it affects your family, then we need to put a hold and think about it. Should we continue to do these things?
Okay, 我们接着来看哥林多前书六章十三节。
Let's continue to look at 1 Corinthians 6:13.
还在哪里？好，我们一起读。
死不会为我苦，不会为死，但神要叫他的两个为人，生死是为一段，乃是为主，主也是为生死。
First Corinthians 6:13, meats for the belly and the belly for the meats. But God shall destroy both it and them. Now the body is not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body.
一个人饿，当然要吃饭。
When you're hungry, of course you have to eat.
不过我们是为了吃，我们吃了才能够继续活。
Because we have to eat to live.
啊，但是不是啊，为了吃东西而活。
But we are not living because we need to eat.
我们这个身体是属主的。
Our body belongs to God.
所以我们或吃或喝都是要为着主。
Therefore, no matter we eat or we drink, it is for God.
做什么事情，我们不仅要问他有没有益处，还要问这是不是为着主。
Things we do, not only do we have to ask it, is it profitable, but we also need to ask it, is it for Him?
所以这个是第三个问题，我们要问。我做这个事情是不是为了主
？So this is the third question we need to ask ourselves: Is all things we do for the Lord?
啊，有一些弟兄姐妹，包括我以前，我们去做工，我们为了什么？
Many brothers, sisters, when we work, why do we go to work?
那很多人说，我去做工，我那么拼命，是看到钱的面上。
Because we want, because of the money.
啊，如果没钱。那你不要叫我干活。
So if there is no money, then do not tell me to work.
啊， 我在这里做过一个见证。
I did a testimony over here.
我十二岁的时候，就没有读书，然后出去给人家放羊。
When I was 12, I stopped going to school and I went and raised sheep for others.
我打过铁，也做过绳子，做了很多事情。
I've cast iron, I've tied ropes, I did many things.
我的目的呢，就是要赚钱。
And my goal is to earn more money.
因为那时候我们家，我爸在监狱里头。然后我妈又家庭妇女，没有收入，所以我一门心思就是要赚点钱来帮助家庭。
Because at the time my father is in prison and my mother is a housewife, so my intention is to earn more money for the family.
后来呢，我爸释放以后，他就看我整天在干活。
And when my father was released, he saw me and he saw me working every day.
他说你，他当时问我说你大概赚多少钱
？So he asked me how much money did you earn?
我那时候很骄傲地告诉他，四个月14块钱。
So I'm very proudly I told him in 4 months I made $14.
Okay. 我感谢主，我爸当时不是说不吃不喝。十四块钱太少了，不要赚了。他没有像有一些父母就这样的，这么少的钱，那你为什么要去？我父亲没有这样说。
And thank the Lord, my father didn't say you only make $14 in 4 months. Stop working for them.
我爸问我说，你干活是为谁？为什么
？Instead, my dad asked me, why did you work? Who is it for?
这个不是明摆的嘛，就是为钱嘛。
And I said, isn't it obvious? It's for the money.
他说你这样不行。
And he said, you cannot continue like this.
他说你这样永远也赚不到钱。
He said, like this, you will never earn enough money.
你干活只有一个目标，就是为了主。
And it should be for you to work. There is only one goal is.For the Lord.
有钱没钱，你就尽心做。
Whether there's money or not, you do it with all your will.
然后呢，你有没有钱就看神给不给你。
And if you have money or not, it depends on God.
你做不是为了钱，是为了主。
But when you do it, it's not for the money, but for God.
我从那时候就把观念改变了。
And since that time, I have changed my mindset.
然后，跟弟兄姐妹讲，从那时候到现在，我从来没有过就是做了没有钱的。
And from that point until now, there's never been one incident that I work and I haven't received any money.
Okay, 好，我就要再讲另外一个事情，就是我认识一个传道人，他80多岁的时候。有人问他。
And another thing, I know another preacher, and in his 80s, somebody asked him.
因为他做传道人呢，他不是在哪里做，牧师啊，或者做什么，他是没有工资的。
And him being a preacher, he doesn't earn anything. He earns no money.
所以有一个年轻人就有一次他讲完道，他就问他说。那你没有一个地方雇佣你，那你的钱从哪里来
？And one day after he preached, a young man asked him, "If nobody is hiring you, then where does your income come from?"
然后他这个传道人就反问这个年轻人说：“如果你现在干活，你没有这个老板不给你钱，你怎么办
？”And the preacher asked him, "If you are working,Today, and your boss do not pay you, then what are you going to do?
那个年轻人 I quit.
那个年轻人说我不干了。
然后这个年长的传道人说 I will do the same.
这个年长的说我也不干了。
我也不干了。如果没有钱我不干了。
So if there's no money, I'm not going to do it.
然后这个老的传道人讲说，那我说实在的话，我现在没有机会可以 quit。
But does elder preacher say I? But right now I do not have the opportunity to quit.
为什么
？And why is that?
因为神从来不会亏待的，是不是
？Because God is always good to us.
你去给神做工，神会亏待我们吗？
不会。When you do work for God, God will not do you wrong.
所以他侍奉神八十多年，他想要。炒神的鱿鱼一直炒不成。
So therefore, when he in the 80 years he served God, when he wanted to fire God, there's no way he could do it.
因为神太准时了，你需要的时候他的工资来了，而且他付给我们往往超过我们所付的工。
Because God is so on time, whenever you have needs, He will.Give you the needs and beyond what you wish for.
所以今天呢，我们无论做什么，为着主，你不用去担心，哦，神会让我没有钱了，让我挨了，绝对不会。
So today we do not have to worry because no matter what we do, God knows and He will fulfill our needs.
我希望弟兄姐妹，我们的工作观必须因着神的话而改变。
So I'm hoping that, brother and sister, our mindset, through God's words, we need to change.
接下去，我们看一下，下一页。凡事不都造就。
Not all things edify.
Okay, 我们一起读。凡事都可行，但不都有益处。凡事都可行，但不都受益处。无论何人，不要求自己的益处，乃是要求别人的益处。
First Corinthians chapter 10 verse 23 to 24. All things are lawful for me, but all things are not profitable. All things are lawful for me, but all things edify not. Let no man seek his own, but every man another's wealth.
我们不要以为只要不犯罪不作恶的事情我就可以做。
So let's not think that as long as we're not committing a crime or doing a sin, then we could do it.
造就人英文叫做 build up a person.
To build up a person.
Okay. 比如说我们知道所有的食物你祷告过神已经接近了。
For example, we know that all the food that we, as long as we pray, God have cleansed it.
Okay, 如果有人把一个祭过偶像的食物摆在你面前。
So when somebody bring you a food that has been worshipped to idol.
Offered to idol.
Offered to idol.
那你有些人呢？反正我已经求神接近了，接近了没有
？So something,、okay. something I have asked God to cleanse it. Is it?
神就没有办法接近这样被能神有办法，神是全能的，可以。但是我为什么不吃呢
？But is God going to cleanse this? God can, but will He do it? That's offered to idol.
圣经里头说，为了那别人的良心。
It said in the Bible, it's for the good heart of others.
如果我这样做，他说：“哎，以后也可以，某某传道人都这样做，那我也可以这样做。”
Because if they do it once, then somebody else is going to say, "Oh, this person did it, now I'm going to do it too."
他没有得到造就，反而你让他在这方面跌倒，或者去做了不应该做的事情。
And this person is not edified, but he is tripped.Understand, so we cannot do it.
Okay. 我们知道每个地方都是有红灯区。
We know there is red light district in many places.
这个弟兄呢，这个传道人刚好住的地方呢，就是必须走过红灯区，然后才到他的家。
And this preacher, the place he lived. whenever he goes out, he have to walk through the red light district.
如果啊，这个因为走红灯区呢，路很直。如果他要到什么地方，他也必须走红灯区。
And the path is very straight, so wherever he go, he have to cross the red light district.
那这个弟兄，为了省时间嘛，我整天这样做可以吗？你们觉得可以不可以？
So this brother, to save time, he walks over every day. Do you think he could do it?
但是这个弟兄没有这样做，他每一次都绕一大圈，要花更多的时间，然后呢才出去或者回来。
But this brother, he did not do that. Every time he goes out, he has to go very far to avoid the red light district.
有些人就会跟他讲说：“你何必呢？”
Some say, "Why do you have to do that?"
他说：“大家都知道你是住在那个地方。”
They say everyone knows you live there.
他说：“是，这些，比如说这些在真宗教会里头很多人年的人都知道啊，知道这个传道人。但是如果有一个新人来呢？”
He said yes.Everyone that's been here for a long time, they know I live there, but what if we have a newcomer?
然后他有一天走过那个地方的时候，你就跟他从那里出来，哦，某传道人也去红灯区。
And one day the newcomer walks over there and he sees me coming out of the red light district and he's going to say, oh, this preacher also goes to the red light district.
那个人没有得到造就，因为你所做的没有得到造就。
Therefore, that person that saw it, he is not edified.
还有一个不能制造别人的道，就是说你讲的话是让别人看清另外一个人，而不是让别人尊敬另外一个人。
And another thing that does not build others is the words you speak. It's to let somebody see clearly this person, but not to edify the others.
所以在教会里头。如果我们要讲到弟兄姐妹的时候，请注意，不要因为我们讲的话，让别人对这个弟兄或这个姐妹看低了。
So when we speak about our brother and sister in church, we need to be very careful, not using our words and let other brothers and sisters look down upon the person we're talking about.
Okay, 我们讲的话应该。让这个弟兄或者这个姐妹得造就，让别人尊敬他。
The words we speak about the brother and sister should be the words that edify this brother and sister, so other people pay more respect to them.
如果我们大家都是这样说正面的话、正能量的话，彼此鼓励。
And if the words we say are all positive and full of encouragement,
我想我们的教会会不一样。
That I believe that our church will be different.
如果我们整天就是，哦，某弟兄在那边唱歌，没唱得很好，从头到尾都唱得很好，但是后面他气不够了，然后你就说他唱得很好，但是不够气。
So if we say a brother, he's been singing really good throughout the whole session, except at the end that he is out of breath.
他不够气，这个需要讲吗
？But did you have to mention that he's out of breath in the end?
不需要讲的嘛，是不是
？We didn't need to mention that, right?
Okay. 哇，这个姐妹啊，看起来是挺可爱的，但是矮了点。
The sister, she is very cute, except she's a little short.
这矮了点需要讲吗
？Do we have to say that she's a little short?
所以我们真的是。要在教会里头多鼓励弟兄姐妹讲正面的话。
Therefore, we need to talk positive in church and encourage one another.
Okay. 接着，凡事要什么？
荣耀。
Okay, 我们一起来读这段话。
所以，无论在做事或说，无论做什么，
都要被荣耀神
而行。
Okay, 好，这句话也是我们最后要讲的一点。
And lastly, do all to the glory for God. Whether therefore ye eat or drink or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God.
他说所有的事情 And 无论做什么
，and it's whatever we do，
神得荣耀吗
？Do God have the glory？
所以我们在讲一句话的时候，如果每个人都问这几个问题
，So whenever we speak， if everyone asks all these questions，
整个教会我们每个人都做一件事情之前都问这些问题，我想。这个教会的弟兄姐妹的灵命会不一样。
And if everyone in our church, before we do anything, we ask all these questions, then our spiritual life will be different.
圣经里头一直叫我们要谨慎。
In the Bible, it kept telling us to be alert.
行事为人要谨慎。
Whatever we do, we need to be cautious.
那谨慎，它具体的讲应该怎么样呢？
So in detail, what is it?
Okay, 我们再从开头看下来。Okay. 好，下面，再下一页。Okay. 我们读，凡事
都有秘书，
凡事不受瑕疵。凡事皆是贵主，然后凡事不都照顾，凡事为荣耀。
So all points, not all things profit. All things for the Lord, not be brought under the power of any. Not all things edify, and do all to the glory of God.
Okay, 最后我们一起念。
希望如果老道的一位教授
也一样的劝勉我们。凡事都可行，但不可行。凡事都可行，但不可造成人。无论做什么，都要为着人。要记住，我们在人，在基督里造成的，唯要在我们心上，要行神所预备叫我们的事情的。
So lastly.Let's hope from the exhort of Paul to the Corinthian church, which also exhorts us. All things are lawful for me, but all things are not profitable. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any. All things are lawful for me, but all things edify not. Whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God. And let's remember, we are edified by God within Christ to do good and to do what is prepared by God for us to do.
谢谢，
谢谢 ，Thank you。
OK， 最后我们来唱一首歌，这首歌告诉我们要为谁而活，我们去做。OK， 请起立。
Let's rise and sing Living Jesus。
是想过夜
神。
Praise the Lord, thank you.
谢谢牧师给我们带来这么好。